العزيز الرحيم لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون
The Prophet ﷺ said, "None of you will have faith until he wishes for his brother what he wishes for himself." I wish for a meal for iftar.
I wish for a drink to end my fast.
I wish for a joyous Eid. For some, wishes are simple needs that we can fulfill. This Ramadan, join AMA in fulfilling the wishes of families in need across the world.
No one will care for you like your parents will care for you. At Anur Education Center, we give children a loving home, a boys and girls hostel. We provide them with clothing, food, and education. Be the child's parent by sponsoring a student for 18,000 rand or 1,500 rand per month. Anur Education Center, a place where children call home.
وكل شيء أحصيناه في إمام مبين واضرب لهم مثلا أصحاب القرية إذ جاء
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وقوت الأرواح وغذائها وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. My dearly beloved Jamaat al-Muslimin and all our viewers on Facebook and YouTube, I greet you with the universal greetings of love, peace and mercy. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, today it gives me great pleasure and honor to introduce to you our honorable guest and speaker, born in Egypt, raised in Egypt, the Honorable Sheikh Dr. Hani Al-Banna, who is a medical doctor, graduated from Al-Azhar Al-Sharif University in Egypt. He also obtained a diploma in Islamic Studies at the Al-Azhar University. He is a doctor of medicine from the Birmingham University in the UK, the founder of Islamic Relief Worldwide in 1984, is the founder of the Muslim Charities Forum in the UK, president of the Humanitarian Forum, awarded the OBE, which stands for the Order of the British Empire by the late Queen Elizabeth, and he was awarded the Ibn Khaldun Award for promoting understanding between global cultures and faiths. Many, many things still can be said about our honorable guest, but he's a very humble person. He told me, please, I don't want any fanciful introductions. I'm just a servant of Allah, serving the Deen of Islam. Without further ado, I welcome and present to you the Honorable Dr. Sheikh Hani Al-Banna from Egypt, who will be speaking to us on the beautiful topic, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the humanitarian. فليتفضل مشكورا يا فضيلة الأستاذ.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الحمد لله الذي هدانا الإيمان ما كنا نهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين من تبع هديهم مختوم إلى يوم الدين أجمعين. آمين آمين آمين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We don't want to prove that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the final and the ultimate and the teacher of all prophets and the Imam of all. We don't want to prove this. It's done long time ago. We don't want to prove that Quran is a message of God. إنا نحن نزلنا الذكرى وإنا له لحافظون. We have to be very proud and honored of being the followers of the teacher of all the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. The followers of the Imam of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم أجمعين. No need for us at the time of Islamophobia to prove that. إذا خطبهم الجهلون, when the ignorant one make mockery about you, about us, say peace be upon you and proceed to deliver the message of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is your message. Don't be distracted, the young people, by what they say about you or about us. No. You have a message to save, message to help, message to love. Our life on this planet, if we compare it to the life of Hazrat Nuh عليه السلام, saying that Nuh lived for 1,000 years. 1,000 years. That means before Allah, وَيَوْمٍ عَنْدَ رَبِّكَ كَأَلْفِ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تَعَدُّونَ. One day before Allah is 1,000 years what you count. So Nuh عليه السلام lived for one day, not for 1,000 years. And when Allah said that the day of Allah is 50,000 years of what we count, that means Nuh عليه السلام lived for less than 1.5 hours of the days of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. This is how long life is. Don't buy this life and lose the life to come. The life to come in the grave, which you will see our amal, which is good. The window in the grave will show your place in heaven. Which is bad, the window in the grave will show me my place in hellfire. Second life in the grave, which what we need to prepare ourselves, our soul has to prepare itself for what it prepared for tomorrow. Tomorrow is in the grave. Then tomorrow is on the straight path, Sirat al-Mustaqim. Then tomorrow is in the barzakh. And tomorrow, either hellfire, wal-'iyadhu billah, or heaven, inshallah, for all of you. One, the life of Hazrat Nuh was less than 1.5 hours of what we count. Have we seen Ramadan? How fast it went through, like speed of light. One of the day sign of day of judgment, the small ones, is the year will be equivalent like a month. The month will be equivalent like a week. The week will be equivalent like a day. And the day like an hour. It's going very fast. And here, when I was on the plane yesterday, or maybe this morning, because Brother Yusuf let me to wait for him, I was trying to write something for you about al-hub, which is love. Al-hub, ata. وبقاء وبناء. Love is giving. Love is existence. Love is construction. سخاء وسماء وحياء. Love is generosity. Love is something, its ceiling is high. Nobody can rise to the height of love. And love is chastity. حياء. 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 Chastity. Whom we love? We love ourselves, anfusna. We love our darlings. What kind of love we give to them? We love my wife. When my wife loves me, it be a transaction of love into action, into moral action, into valuable community action. Love our children. Once upon a time, Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz, the sixth caliph, after Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Al-Hassan, which people denied him that he was Khalifa al-Muslimin, then Umar ibn Aziz. His love to his children was when he was the king of the kings, the Khalifa of an Ummah which was going from China into Andalusia. His daughter came to him and told him at the night of Eid, "Daddy, I don't have a new dress. Can you get me something?" He went to the keeper of the house of Mal. "Tell him, can I borrow my next month's salary to buy clothes for my daughter?" You know what the keeper of the house of Mal told him? "Can you guarantee that you will live for next month to work for your salary?" He said, "No, I can't. Say, I cannot give you." This is how he loved his daughter. So he came back to her, said, "Daughter, shall you not wear a new Eid dress and your father go to heaven? Or shall you wear a new Eid dress and your father can go to hellfire?" Said, "Daddy, no, I will wear the old dress." This is the love of Umar, of not taking a money which he cannot work for it. Review yourself, your kings, your queens, whatever they call themselves, compared to Umar. He died leaving nothing for his children. That's how he loved his children, because he brought them up the way that Allah wants him to bring them up. His cousins from the Umayyad left huge pieces of land, gold and silver, and 10, 20, 30 years later on, the children of Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz were very rich men and women, very highly educated, pious, and the other people, as the historian said, were begging. Because the parents left them for money, left money only for them. Did not leave the feeling of love to Allah and the reflection of this love into the community. If you love your children, educate them and show them the right way. Don't leave a land and property only for them. They will fight one another. Sometimes they backstab and kill one another, actually, to take the land from one another. Well, our parents, how to love them. Our relatives, our neighbors, our friends, our colleague. Islam is about loving others and saving others and helping others. And this is the teacher of humanity who asks us to love everyone, every creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they have been created for us by Allah to serve us. Their worship to Allah is to serve each one of us. And our service to Allah, or our belief in Allah, is to protect them, to help them, to guide them, to save them, and to build the community for them. This is love of whoever surrounding us. My fellow men and women, the citizens of South Africa, I have to love all of them, Muslims or non-Muslims. Treat them fairly, Muslims and non-Muslims, ignorant or educated, not to be only sectarian or following one school of thought or have one understanding from one alim. Islam fiqh is multi-diverse message of understanding, all-inclusive. The greatest ulama in the history of Islam were not Arabs. For people who are not Arab, like most of you, but they managed to master the Arabic language, the language of knowledge, the language of history, the language of deen, the language of culture, the language of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the language of Quran, the language of Sunnah, and the language of Sirah. My fellow men, Muslims and women, male and female. I have to love them. Human being as a whole, outside my country, outside my continent, outside my race. I have to love them. Love life. If we love life, we have to construct life and make it feasible and make it easy for others to live in it. Not to steal, not to sideline, not to push others. If we love life, life is about construction and helping and guiding and saving and empowering the poor ones. Not to be arrogant, not to be superior. No, Muhammad never was an angrant, the man of humanity, and the man humanity stood up for him and is still standing up for him forever. The man whose great-grandfather, Ibrahim, was praying, and the rest of the Prophet behind him when he went to meet Allah in heaven, subhanahu wa ta'ala, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Love your enemy. فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِلْحَمِينَ. Your enemy, convert him to a friend. Convert him to love you. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, يطعمون الطعام على حبه مسكينا ويتيما وأسيرا. Feed out of love the needy, the poor, the yatim, orphans, and the asir. You know what the asir is? The prisoner of war. The one who yesterday was trying to kill you. The one who yesterday was trying to rape your wife, steal your land. Allah said, when you feed him, when he is under your captivity, feed him with love. Ala hubbi. If our ulama do not understand Arabic, they are not ulama. No way. The way forward is to understand the book of Allah, not to repeat it. Half is good, but not good enough. We have to create alim. We have to create scholars in every subject. Love the act of goodness, a'mal al-khayr. Love all creations of God. Love all the prophets of Allah. All the message of Allah. Love Allah, who is creating me, supporting me, protecting me, and saving me. This is love. Love that does not have a personal need. I love this man because I want to marry his daughter or to make business with him. No, love is pure for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? But love for the common good of love. Love does not contain zulm. I love those people. I hate those people. So I make zulm to those people because I love those people. Love does not have zulm in it. Love has a good manner. Khafd al-jinah. To lower yourself to the other people. And this was the character. إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِمُؤْتَمِّمْ مَكَامِ مَخَارِ الرَّبِ. Prophet ﷺ has been sent by Allah for the fulfillment of the best manner of mankind ever. And we cheat, we lie, we backstab, and we steal. This is no good. إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأَتَمِّمْ لِأُتَمِّمْ كَامِ الْأَخْلَاقِ. Love the future so you can build it for the generations to come. Love Jannah and Nar. Loving Jannah, that you want to invite everybody to Jannah. Loving Nar, that you want to protect everybody from coming to hellfire, وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. You are the creation of Allah. We have been ordered by Allah to give you the good life in Jannah and the bad life in where we deceive and we do not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This kind of love is not one way to understand. Love being educated to educate. Learn to teach. Being guided to guide. رشاد والإرشاد. Love is like a big pot. In a big pot. Have a capacity to every good action in life. You can imagine how big the pot of love is. You know when Surah Ayat al-Ikhlas, Ayat al-Kursi. وَسَعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. You don't have a chair for the Imam here. You know the kursi of Allah, the chair of Allah, it is width more than the width of skies and the earth, not the length. We have to imagine how mighty is the might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in whom his chair is wider than the width of skies and the earth. And this is the capacity of the pot of love. Can expand it for each and every one of us when we switch on to what Allah wants us to have in our heart as love. Now, every act of goodness, help, help, help. And this was the sign when Abu Bakr and Umar were competing to clean up the house of the old and the blind woman at night, so nobody can see them. Nobody can see them. It's not the logo. It's not the name of the organization. It's not the sheikh. It's not the imam. It is the sincerity of Umar, Abu Bakr, and each one of them was competing to serve a blind woman at the periphery of Medina without anybody noticing. And he was the Amir. He was the president. He was the Khalifa. Not any ordinary man. This is love. For a blind woman, there's nothing will come out from her. Love al-akhirah. And use al-dunya to build your farmyard in al-akhirah. That's it. As I said, as not me, as the ulama said, the life of Hazrat what's his name? Nuh was less than 1.5 hours of the day in front of Allah. How long will we live for? Sir, sister, brother, still too long. Have more 10 years to go, 15 years to go, 50 years to go. What? One of the small signs of Allah of the day of judgment now is the sudden death. You find on the Facebook nowadays, young people dying all of a sudden. Men and women. So when Azrael or the angel of death comes, he will never take a permission from you to wait. You only ask the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And they told him, what after 1,000 years? Say, I'll take you. Say, take me now. I want to meet Allah. As Hazrat Bilal and others, when they were dying, they were saying, غَدًا أَلْقَى الْأَحِبَّةِ مُحَمَّدًا وَصَحْبَةً. Bilal, when he was dying and his wife was screaming, said, don't weep, my wife. Tomorrow I'll be with the beloved ones. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and his companion. This is love. Love to be with the people that he is the prophet. And the Prophet ﷺ said, Al-mar'u yuhsharu ma'a man yuhib. The one of us will be with the people that he or she loves. See whom we love. Young people, you use a fashion which Allah does not like. And the nuzlak. Male and female. You're the family that Allah will be unhappy with it. Use languages that Allah does not like. And Prophet ﷺ does not like. And when the Prophet sees us nowadays, he said, are these our fellow men and women? Be careful with the fashion which is controlling our life. Be careful with the language that's controlling our life. Be careful with the culture that's controlling our life. See if Allah loves this fashion and the culture and language, or he does not, and our Prophet does not love that. You know what is this big pot? Okay? هذا الوعاء هو وعاء الأنبياء الذين أحبوا الحياة. This pot is the pot of the Prophet and Messenger of Allah who loved life on earth. And they came and sent by Allah to save people and let them to be guided by the teaching of Allah. Some of them were tortured, some of them called names, and some of them were killed, like Zakaria and Yahya alayhim as-salam. This is pot of love given to the people who loved us, so they were doing their best to save us, and we are turning our back to them. And the pot is in each of our bodies. Now, where is your pot of love? It's your heart. Your heart, which is as small as this, could have the capacity of the love of the whole of humanity if you connect it to the source of love, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was taught by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The source of love is Allah. The teacher is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So your heart, our heart, have the capacity of accommodating more than 8 billion human beings. Billions and billions and billions of other creation that Allah created them to serve us. You know this miracle, the small pot here, has the capacity. Because don't ever measure the capacity with our measuring tools. كان البحر مدادا لكلمات ربي ولو كان ولا ولو. If the ocean was the ink that you can write the words of Allah through this ink, لنفذ البحر قبل أن تنفذ كلمات ربي. The ocean will be drying up or dried up, and with another ocean. And this is the knowledge of Allah. You know what? Whom you love? The one who has the knowledge to see how many creation is pregnant at the same time on earth, and how many baby born with animals or insect or fish, whatever you call it, at the same time, and how many people who dying at the same time, and how many children be born healthy, who will be born disabled, will be born death at the same time. And everything in Kitab Mubin, and everything is written by his knowledge in a very well seen, understood book. Don't ever worship the technology which has been created by man, but the worship the man, the Allah who created the technology for you to use. We talk now about artificial intelligence. Yes? You know who was behind it? Start with, to conclude with this one. Because somebody, you know what algorithm means? Algorithm. Algorithm is Al-Khawarizmi. Al-Khawarizmi is from the area of the Balkh. Who started algebra, and all the algorithms that we are using, you know these telephones? It's because of Al-Khawarizmi, who started nearly 1,000 years ago. Huh? Ask yourself and myself to build a computer, just one computer, with all the knowledge and technology that we have. In spite of the fact that the originator was Muslim like us, but he did his duty. What are we doing to carry on? Following the others, or we are completing the journey of Al-Khwarizmi? Knowledge. Iqra is knowledge seeking, not reading and write, not hifz. Iqra is knowledge seeking. Seek knowledge. Teach your children to seek knowledge. And the challenge here, to end my... The challenge here is, get me everybody on earth, high tech, with all the knowledge, to make a system to measure the width of the skies and the earth, the depth of earth, the size or the volume of waters and the number of droplets of water, the number of the sands, the grains of the sands. But Allah has this. The number of falling leaves and the growing leaves. The number of seeds inside every fruit we eat. Can we do that? The challenge here is to let us come back to the teacher who was guiding us to Allah. That's why Muhammad is the teacher of humanity, alayhi salatu wasalam. Muhammad is the teacher of humanity and forever. He was taught by Allah. Don't ever say that Muhammad was ignorant. But Muhammad was taught by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah made him special to be guided and taught by him firsthand. That's why he is a teacher forever. And be proud of him. Don't bend yourself or your back to somebody calling him names or calling Islam names. Those Islamophobes are sick, ignorant. وَإِذَا خَطَبُهُمُ الْجَهَلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. I have no time for you. Because we proceed to suffer, to save, and help humanity. Because Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم did that to help and save humanity. He was given the choice whether he become a king like King David or King Suleiman or become a slave. He said, I would like to be a slave. And miskeen, to be among us, the miskeen. He could have had everything he wanted, but he refused. Because he wanted to be amongst the miskeen, among the slaves, as a teacher of humanity, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is Muhammad, that we celebrate his fashion, we celebrate his language, we celebrate his teaching, sisters and brothers, we celebrate his fashion, his teaching, his language, his moral values, his manner. As Aisha radiallahu anha said, كان خلقه القرآن, his manner was Quranic. وكان قرآنا يمشي على الأرض, and he was a walking Quran on earth. That's Muhammad that we celebrate. Not our leader. Not somebody else. جزاكم الله خير. Oh, I passed the time. Sorry. Sorry. I passed the time. I didn't see this one. I was told to stop at 1:30, but I was carried on. Should have stopped me.
Barakallah. Shukran, Fadilat al-Ustaz.
Not Fadilat, I'm brother. Fadilat is for Sheikh like you.
The Sheikh is an amazing person, wallah. Beautiful personality, very humble. He tell me he's not the Sheikh, I'm the Sheikh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept, jazakallah khair, takbir. May Allah accept the beautiful message from Sheikh Dr. Hani Al-Banna, who is from the UK currently, but born and raised in Egypt. He has a medical doctorate from the graduate as a medical doctor from the Al-Azhar University in Cairo. And he also obtained a diploma in Islamic studies from the Al-Azhar University. He is a doctor of medicine from the Birmingham University in the UK. And he is the founder of Islamic Relief Worldwide in 1984. And his CV goes on and on and on. Alhamdulillah, he has dedicated his life to the service and the dawah of Islam and being a great ambassador of Islam throughout the world. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve the Honorable Sheikh, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Grant him long life that he can continue to be of great service for the Deen and for the worldwide Muslim community. And we thank Brother Yusuf Muhammad from the Islamic Relief for bringing the Sheikh to us. May Allah crown all your efforts with resounding success. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Just a very few announcements. We have been asked to make dua shifa for Haji Abida Furfrey, the wife of Haji Farouk, staying here in Pearl Court, number 6, Gatesville. She's currently in hospital, and all the sick people at home in hospital, may Allah grant them shifa and kamila and afia. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. We have quite a few people going for Hajj. Some have left already, some have arrived safe in Medina, and some straight to Mecca. And those who, some of them will be leaving soon, will be Haji Abdul Aziz Pangakar, his son Azad Ashraf Pangakar, Mansur Kutbuddin Pangakar, and his wife Fatima, and all the other Hujjaj. We pray from the bottom of our hearts that Almighty Allah preserve all our Hujjaj. Allah be with them in this beautiful, most wonderful travel and journey in the life of every Muslim. May Allah grant all our Hujjaj Hajj Maqbool, Hajj Mabrur, and bring them back salamat to their families and friends. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Our Arabic khutbah will be done by Hafiz Ali Pankakar, and the Jummah Salah will be led by Hafiz Mayer Didriks, inshallah. So if Mayer Didriks can just come to the front as well. Shukran. Jazakallah khair and by yatramakasi.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين رب اختمنا بالخير برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمه الله تعالى وبركاته.
الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر اشهد ان لا اله الا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدنه ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا وينذر الذين قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا ما لهم به من علم ولا لآبائهم كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم إن يقولون إلا كذبا. الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي يسبح له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة تنجي قائلها من عذاب أليم. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله حبيب الرحمن الرحيم صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. وقال تعالى هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون. هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. وقال تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. صدق الله العلي العظيم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله أستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولوالدي ولوالديكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
اللهم صل وسلم وزد وعنم ونفدل وبارك جلالك وكمالك على زين عبادك واشرف عبادك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وصحبه وسلم سلم رضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل صحابة أجمعين.
الحمد لله الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر والصلاة والسلام على سيد البشر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين. وقال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن خلفاء الراشدين ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين وعن بقية الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين وتابع التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. الخاسرين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا عزيز يا غفار يا مولانا يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.
Kindly straighten the soft, please. Heels on the line, shoulder to shoulder, please.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا وجعل فيها سراجا وقمرا منيرا، وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا، وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا، وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما، والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما، والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما، إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر، إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله، استغفر الله، استغفر الله العظيم التواب الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم، ونتوب إليه ونسألك توبة والمغفرة إنه هو التواب الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام، تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، سمعنا وتطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. الفاتحة.
اللهم إنك تعلم أن هذه القلوب قد اجتمعت على محبتك والتقت على طاعتك وتوحدت على كلمتك وتعاهدت على نصرة شريعتك، فأطلق اللهم ربط له وأدم مده وهدها سبلها واشرح صدورها فايد الإيمان بك وجميل التوكل عليك، أحياها بمعرفتك وأحياها بمعرفتك وأحياها بمعرفتك، ومتها اللهم على الشهادة في سبيلك، إنك نعم المولى ونعم النصير. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبع هداه واختار من يوم الدين أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، سلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.
The Prophet ﷺ said, "None of you will have faith until he wishes for his brother what he wishes for himself." I wish for a meal for iftar.
I wish for a drink to end my fast.
I wish for a joyous Eid. For some, wishes are simple needs that we can fulfill. This Ramadan, join AMA in fulfilling the wishes of families in need across the world.
No one will care for you like your parents will care for you. At Anur Education Center, we give children a loving home, a boys and girls hostel. We provide them with clothing, food and education. Be the child's parent by sponsoring a student for 18,000 rands or 1,500 rand per month. Anur Education Center, a place where children call home.